so I have to turn that off when I'm done. All righty then. God morning. Good morning. God morning. All right, hello.
Hello.
Let's say good morning.
Good morning.
All right. Thank you so much for being here. Welcome to our Sunday celebration service. I'm Reverend Liz, co-minister, and this is
Reverend Divine.
Yeah, and we are the co-ministers here. Are you on? She's working on that.
I am now. Oh, my God. Okay, that's like step, way too much.
Step to the side. Perhaps there's feedback.
Excuse me. I'm not trying to blast any of us out of here.
It's all right. Keep
talking. Hello, hello, hello. Hi. Better? Thank you. Thank you.
Life is an experiment, right? So everything is experimental. And we are going to live stream today, so hello to the folks online. This is our debut on several levels, one of them being live streaming, and the other is that we have our new music leader, Elizabeth Huditz.
Woo-hoo!
And we're gonna have live music along with some another singer. I believe Amy Augenstein is in the house. Can you raise your, Woo! Let's say hi to Amy. We have Elizabeth's husband, partner. I don't know if you're in that state. Husband, it is a husband. Al Hager, who is also present. And we'll have Gerald Gates, as you all know him, he's on drums. So we got a full house of music and laughter and love that's happening here today. And you are the reason we're here. We are here to be together in a community. And wherever you are on your spiritual path, we want to welcome you and know that we celebrate the divine that you are, because we see everyone as an expression of divine love. And we're just here to remember who we are and to come together and learn about some spiritual practices and ways that we can connect and thrive instead of just survive. Are you in?
Yeah. Yes?
Okay. All right, good. Great. Anyone here for the second time? If so, if you just raise your hand, give a little wave. Hi, thank you so much for coming back. Welcome back. And then anyone here for the very first time, if you'd raise your hand so we can give a wave. Oh, great, awesome, good to see you all. Thank you so much for being here. We'd love to meet up with you after the service. Today we'll have only a short period after the service because we have our monthly council meeting at 11:30. So we'd be happy to meet with you, get a little exchange. And we do have something called a welcome packet. We've got a few of these put together. They'll be outside on the black table. So pick one up and then you can find out more about us in that way. Also on that table, there is a prayer box. So if you have something heavy in your heart and you would like to have lightness in your heart instead, or you want a prayer request for someone,
or you want to celebrate something and you'd like prayer just around that celebration too.
You mean you can pray and give thanks for things?
You betcha.
Right. Awesome. A few announcements, and just so you know that all of our website is where you find all of our information. We have a couple, who knows what sacred seva is? If you know what that word is. Yeah, a few of you. Sacred seva is service. It's a way of serving. And it's also known as a spiritual practice. So y'all do spiritual practices, like maybe meditation, prayer, study. Well, another form of spiritual practice is to give in service. Because when we give, we are giving to the divine in so many ways. We can give through our time, our talents, and our treasures. And there's opportunities here at Unity to step into that. Leanne, if you would stand up so I can just acknowledge who you are. There's Leanne Gable, who is overseeing the facilities, and we're doing the adopt.
Passing clipboards right now anyway. But
Neil and I were here yesterday morning for a couple of hours, and we just finished completely weeding that big black back flower bed.
Nice.
It's actually lovely.
Let's give love to all those folks that are already signed up and for those that are going to sign up because, you know, together it takes a village, right? It's not just one or two people. There's something, a community is when we come together. And we also have on Sunday mornings opportunities. Right now we usually have a couple of people and there's people that are going in and out of town. So if you could step in and talk to Julie afterwards, you know, just coming in and being a greeter or doing a little spot cleaning after the service or helping with the coffee setup. It's easy and it helps us out because having two or three people, that gets to, that's, you know what I'm saying. So I don't have to say anything more. Thank you for stepping up and helping out on Sunday mornings. And just so you know, we are staying safe with the mask wearing. You can have it off as long as you're vaccinated. You know, there's things going on still in the world. We haven't totally eliminated the COVID. So thank you for your participation in such things. When you're out walking around, please put the mask on. Also when you're singing, because there's air blowing and projecting. So if you're singing along, we're gonna ask that you put this on. That's another reason why we have the first three rows open so that the singers are not projecting onto you. So thank you for your consideration and taking that step. Wednesday nights, we have meditation on the first and third Wednesdays at 6 p.m. here, and we're in the Roomy Room. We're also doing this live on Facebook. So if you aren't coming in, you could just tune in at 6 o'clock for that. On the second and fourth, we're having a grief and loss spiritual support group led by Reverend Divine.
And just so that you know, the word grief does not mean death. Sometimes people think, oh, I don't need that. No one died. It's about support for forms of loss, which most of us have gone through quite a lot of in the past year and a half. So if you feel like that's a form of nurturing and support for you, then please, it's here at 6 o'clock. I don't have anything going on online. But if somebody's interested or people are interested in something online because that's what they're more comfortable or they live out of the area, let me know that so that we can put that together. My goal is to create safety and confidentiality. So,
thank you, Reverend Divine. And I have one more thing to announce, but I have a quick question for you. How many of you would be interested in a class called Aging as a Spiritual Practice? Anyone? Anybody interested in aging as a spiritual practice? Okay, I just wanted to see your hands. If you want to write down what time in the box that's out there for your prayer requests, but also you can put a suggestion or say, I'm interested. That way I know, and you can put your contact on it. We're looking at when we could do that. Do you want it in the daytime or in the evening? It's okay to do it in the day, especially. So aging as a spiritual practice is something we're interested in. And we already have a class set up, and it's called How to Pray Without
Talking to God.
Without talking to God. Have
it's
you
possible.
Ever? Right?
Yeah.
So this is a book by Reverend Linda Martello-Witsette, and we are starting that on Tuesday, August 3rd. It's 7 weeks. It's in person here at the church. It's 6 p.m. until 7:30. We have sign-up sheet today, so if you're interested in learning more about different kinds of prayer, perhaps increasing your own awareness of how prayer works, and to learn the unity method of prayer, and to just contrast and compare them, and to really get a deeper understanding of that power that we all have as prayers. And it is a prerequisite. We are going to start a prayer chaplain. Divine is going to be leading that in the fall. So we would like you to have an understanding of prayer with this class before we enter into that deeper service of being a prayer chaplain. So at this moment, let us pray. So I'm going to invite you to just go within. And just take a breath in together. And let it go. Another deep centering breath in. And release, let go. And now just take a moment in the silence to be aware of your breath. As we become aware of the breath, we become present to this present moment, to the presence that is breathing me, that is breathing you, that is breathing all of creation. And so we open today's service. We open our hearts. We open our minds. We open to the love of Great Spirit that surrounds us, that fills us, flows through us. Love is breathing us. It's in the air. It's in the seats. It's in our bodies. And so we give thanks as we come together this morning, recognizing the divine presence that is peace and harmony, that is joy and laughter, that is wholeness and health and well-being. We celebrate this service and we give thanks. We give thanks for Reverend Divine for the message that she brings to us today. We give thanks for our new music leader, Elle, and for the musicians that accompany and also sing with her. Mm-hmm. We give thanks for our other staff members, for Julie in the office, Andres in the sound tech booth, for Stacy, our youth director. We give thanks for the volunteers and those who stepped into Sacred Savo, and we give thanks for Unity of Fort Collins for being a sacred place to come, a safe place to come and to explore and to remember who we are. So with great, great gratitude, we release this word knowing it is already activated, for it is believed and it is received. And so with joy and gratitude and love, if you'd like to anchor that with me, please say,
and so it is.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So normally in the past, pre-COVID, we had songbooks. We're choosing not to use songbooks at this point and having things to pass out and pass around. And we have, in the past, used a screen to have words put up on the screen. And however, we have drummers and such, so we're not having a screen, but we have alternative ways of facilitating and doing certain things. So I know some of you, most of you may know this, but for those that don't, we want to include you. So if you care to follow the words, I'm going to read a phrase, and if you would just repeat it back, that way everyone knows what they could say if they choose to. Our unity blessing. First line is, our unity centers us in light and peace.
Our unity centers us in light and peace.
Allowing us to recognize our God within.
Allowing us to recognize our God within.
And to radiate that love to the world.
And to radiate that love to the world.
And so it is.
And so it is.
Thank you so much. And now we're going to have our first song with L. Elizabeth Huditz. Let's give her some love.
Thank you. Oh, okay. And this is a song I selected because I'm thinking you might know it. It's John Lennon's Imagine. So please join in if you know it. And Gerald's going to help me out on this. Imagine there's no heaven, It's easy if you try. No hell below us, above us only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. And no religion too. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will be as one. Imagine no possessions. It's easy if you try. Nothing to kill or die for. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will be as one.
Thank you.
Thank you. I say yes to the joy that invites me in this moment. Joy is the call of my heart. Whether I am at work or play, I bring a spirit of joyfulness to everything I do. More than a mood or an attitude, joy is part of me and mine to live and to share. Like all aspects of my divine identity, joy flowers in my consciousness when I hold joyful thoughts and feelings. I express my joy as the excitement of anticipation, fascination at a new discovery, deep satisfaction in a relationship, and the tranquil glow from communing with God in prayer. My joy is contagious, and I love to share in it. I have feelings of joy when I take part in a friend's or family member's joyous moments, their celebrations and accomplishments. I feel quiet joy when I offer encouragement, and even when I give comfort, grateful to share the care and love of God. Rejoice always. 1 Thessalonians 5:16.
Today's focus is devotion, and part of that is living in the moment. So I just love Jason Mraz, and you're welcome to, you're welcome to sing along if you know it. If this life is one act, why do we lay all these traps? Put them right in our path when we just want to be free. I will not waste my days making up
to me. So I just let go of what I know I don't know. And I know I only do this by living in the moment, living my life easy and breezy, peace in my mind, got peace in my heart, peace in my soul. Oh, wherever I'm going, I'm already home by living in the moment. I'm letting myself off the hook for things I've done. I let the past go past. Now I'm having more fun. I'm letting go of the thoughts that do not make me strong. And I believe this way can be the same for everyone. And if I fall asleep, I know you'll be the one who'll always remind me to live in the moment, living my life easy and breezy, peace in my mind, got peace in my heart, got peace in my soul, wherever I'm going. I'm already home. Tried more than once to just make sure, but I was denied the future I'd been searching for. I spun around and searched no more by living in the moment, living my life easy and breezy, peace of my mind, got peace in my heart, peace of my soul. Oh, wherever I'm going, I'm already home. I'm letting myself off the hook for things I've done. I let my past go past. Now I'm having more fun. I'm letting go of the thoughts that do not make me strong. And I believe this way can be the same for everyone.
I like that song too.
That was awesome. Okay. Wanting to be respectful of our live streamers, so I don't want to block anything, excuse me. Wow, living in the moment, and that is so much of what devotion is all about. This month we've been talking about the power of zeal, and there's different components of zeal, devotion being one of them. The reason that we often speak about things from Reverend Linda Martella-Whitsett out of the Divine Audacity book is because she breaks down the 12 powers super easy breezy and uses little vignettes that make it easy to relate to. That's why I like to read it and I like to work off of it. So devotion being an aspect of zeal, zeal is energy and where we direct energy. Oftentimes, I'm sure you've had an experience where you've had a plan for something and you've put so much energy into it that you fizzled right out. And so you started a project, perhaps, or perhaps many projects, and they're all over your house or your office, and you just couldn't quite get the stamina to push through. So devotion is about paying attention to the present moment, reminding ourselves that wherever we put our energy and our intensity is where we get more back. So I want to read a little something that she shared because I thought it was super amazing. Young man comes in to a super martial artist teacher, world-renowned kind of guy. And he says to the teacher, I want to be the best martial artist. How long do you think that might take for me in study? And the martial artist thinks for just a quick moment and says, at least 10 years. And the young man looks at him and says, oh, 10 years? Thinking, I don't have 10 years to put into this. Because, you know, many of us are instant gratification. We want it this very minute. And so he says, okay, well, what about this? How about if I, study more than any one of your students ever has? How about that? And I, dedicate all my time. How long then do you think it might take? And the martial artist teacher sits and acts like he's being very perplexed by the whole thing and, sits with it and says, well, in that case, it's probably going to be 20 years. And the young man's about ready to fall out of his chair. He's like, wait a minute. I just told you I was going to commit all this extra time. How could it possibly be double? And the master says, well, when one eye is fixed upon your destination, you only have one eye left to find the way. And how often do we spend a tremendous amount of time way out there? Like we're not in the present moment. That's what is so awesome about that song, living in the moment. We're usually, because we're goal-driven, we're raised that way as a society, we're already on to the next thing and the next thing and the next thing. And the thought of stopping to smell the roses, well, it's a really nice little saying, but do we actually stop to take little snippets in and just get joy out of that? So devotion to me is... And Linda says this. She says, it's necessary to be present in the moment, engaged, pressing forward to the future, but it is necessary to live in the present in order to get to the future. And I want to ask you, how many of you do any kind of morning grounding? I'm not talking about prayers, and I'm not talking about meditation. Those are fantastic and they're great, but something that actually anchors you for the day. And the reason that this is really important, because we're doing machines, we're not human beings, we're human doers. We do all the time. So having a morning grounding where you think about, what do I want to have in the day? What are my tasks before me for the day? And what qualities do I want to bring in so that if I have something come up for me, I don't go awry? I can actually take a moment and regroup and tell myself it's okay and remind myself of the qualities I told myself I was going to give myself. Like, how about clarity and patience, perhaps compassion? Or you get the idea. Things that are going to be around your day. So the reason that this is important for me in my world is having come from Silicon Valley, where everything speeds faster than the speed of light, and I just got back from visiting where, you're driving in the car with somebody like your brother, praying that you don't get in a car accident because he's right on top of someone before he hits his brakes. I had to keep breathing and telling myself it's okay. And I asked him numerous times, please slow down just a little bit because I'm actually frightened. See, because I've gotten a little more used to driving here a little more slowly, about a fourth of the cars, and so it just stressed me out a lot. Another example, how many of you have had a project, for instance, and a project manager that you were supposed to report something to, and maybe you clashed with this person, you know, for whatever reason, you just couldn't connect with them, and you always had to do your best because you just saw things differently. Well, if you go into that meeting already anticipating, this is going to be a hot mess, and my day is going to be terrible the rest of the day, how do you think that might be for you all day long? Because you've already set yourself up to have a really miserable day. As opposed to, okay, I've got myself solid and anchored, and I'm actually going to tell myself that today I'm going to be very patient and have a different way of being with my project manager so that we might have a different experience together with each other. That might feel nice. And if we don't, I can take a moment afterwards and just kind of regroup so that I don't let the rest of the day continue on that path. Ever set up something on an auto pay and let go of it thinking it's all set up and you need not worry? I'm sure we've all done that. I thought I set up my car that I had refinanced on an auto pay, and it was done and everything was great. So on my trip, I didn't give thought to the fact that my car note wasn't being paid. And I get home and I'm checking banking stuff and I see that it's not. And I go right into an immediate spin where I could fizzle right out. And then I stop myself. And I said, okay, well, you obviously didn't do something correct and you're going to make a phone call and you're going to get help and it's going to be perfect. And that's what I did. But in between that point and when I noticed that I had not had it removed, I went into this frantic anger, frustration, making somebody wrong, and then had to stop and say, but that's not what I want to have today. So I'm going to calm myself down. Worked out beautifully, thanked the man, told him he was my angel for the day, and went on with it. But you could see that having a morning grounding is valuable to you so that as things come up throughout the day, you're not at effect to it. You're not in reaction to the point where all day long you're not even conscious that you're chanting, I knew this day would be, add in your own word. And instead, you get a chance to just stop. Now, being human doing machines, most of us have a list we make every day. And then we look at the list, and then because we think we can, we probably add a few more things to it. I know my wife does every day. She makes her list and adds a few more things to it. Because the goal of the day is to see how much stuff we can get done, right? We're about the list, and we feel happy that we're checking stuff off the list, giving ourselves praise, good job. And we judge the quality of the day based on how much we checked off the list. Now, have you been present to anything else that might have occurred in the day? No, because you'd be derailed from your list checking. You wouldn't have time to stop perhaps and visit with a colleague or make a call to someone you said you were going to make a call, because that would throw you off your list. And then what happens at the end of the day? Most of us review the list. Maybe if we got everything done, we praise ourselves or validate, good job, I did a good job. Or we look at the list, which, by the way, we created, and we look at the things we didn't get done. Ring anyone's bell? We didn't get this done, we didn't get that done. And then we start being angry, frustrated, berating ourselves because we didn't get something done. And usually it was the last few things we added to the list that we thought we would get done. So how does that set you up to have a good day? Does it give you any joy to actually work through your list? And for some of you, it does. It's a sense of satisfaction and pride. But where is your beingness in this? Where is your beingness? So many of you know I was
back in California, where I'm from. Hadn't seen my mother and brother for a year and a half. And I'm very close to my family, so that was very hard. My grandmother, she's my grandmother. Woo! I'm channeling my grandmother now. Okay. My mother is an elder, and she's very frail. And she's at that last piece of her life. So I was kind of geared how I would need to be when I went home. And the only thing I really had on my list was go to get Pete's coffee and have really good Thai food numerous times. And maybe see a couple of colleagues. That was the only thing. And then visit with family. Couple days before, my mother calls me, wants me to go to a few appointments with her. Her voice is very, very frail, and I'm all of a sudden reminded, oh, this isn't really a vacation. It's kind of like a connection time with family. So whatever I thought I might be doing for fun, let me revise that a little. Let me back up a couple of steps and say, probably not going to happen, because then I realized I needed to be very present to my mom. And it shifted the whole vibe of what I thought I was going to be about. And I'm glad I had the few days to shift the vibe so I could again ground myself for it being a different experience. And I get there, and my mom's doing her very best to pretend that things are great. She figures she can fake it. And the reason I mentioned my grandmother is my grandmother always did that. On the phone, she could talk to you for 5 minutes, you'd have no clue of how she was doing, okay? But if you were with her in person, it would take you only 10 minutes to figure that out. So after part of the evening, I already got what was going on. And my mother's really thinking she's doing a great job. Now, we planned this trip because it was our birthday week. Now, the 4th of July was her birthday. And we did movies and stuff to make it light and pleasant and joyful. And she's apologizing for not having a good day. I can only tell you, the week for me was an opportunity to experience where my mother really is at in her life. It required a lot of compassion. It required a lot of patience. It required me having permission to go in the other room often and cry and then pull it back together. Because when you see someone close to the end, it's real. And crying is more out of gratitude that they're perhaps having a completion. But what I promised myself on the trip was that I was going to every morning go for my morning walk, walk downtown. She lives in a little community called Willow Glen, which is a part of San Jose. So I walked downtown to get my coffee every day. And I found that the walking and paying attention to flowers and trees and just different things that were familiar to me was a way of me calming myself down and being present to the presence. See, I couldn't think about what was going to happen days later. I had to stay right in the moment. And one day I had planned to meet one of my sister reverends for coffee. And I walked down. And I'm a little early, and this little community is a place where there's dogs everywhere. Everyone's got a dog on a leash, or two. And I think that some people borrow a neighbor's dog just to be able to be part of that little community. You know, they, let's bring the neighbor's dog, and it's good. And everyone connects and socializes, and there's little groups that meet every day for their coffee and their bagel. So it's a quaint little area. And I'm waiting, and I see this lovely gentleman walking with his little chihuahua, and he sits down at a table, and he puts the little dog on the table. And the first thing I'm thinking is, get your dog's butt off that table. People eat here. That's gross. But then I stopped and watched the joy in this man's face. He's cuddling and picking up the dog, and he's hugging it. And my heart is so filled with joy watching this amidst everyone's busyness. So, of course, I go up to him and say a few things about what a beautiful connection you have with your dog. It looked like he'd had this dog a while, and they had a really beautiful bond. The man tells me, It's a rescue dog he got 5 days ago. 5 days ago, and he's like just hugging and kissing and just all over this little dog, and the little dog's just kissing him back. And he says to me, what person would just let go of this little dog? I took it to the vet to see if it was chipped, to see maybe if it got loose. No. So I took the dog, and then he kept saying, with this magnificent gleam of love in his eyes, who would do such a thing? And I said to him, I don't know, but here's the blessing. You have him now, and you two get to be together, and you two get to have this sacred, special bond that I can see right before me. And I gotta tell you, watching you two together gives my heart joy, and I'm certain that's exactly why you get to be with this little dog. And he smiled, and his face lit up, and he goes, you get it. Yeah, you understand. And I said, I do. Now, that's what that was about for me, was being in that very present moment. And the fact that I can connect that deeply to something that happened a week and a half ago and still feel that joy in my heart, this is why our being this human doing, we have to remember. We've got to remember to slow down. We've got to remember that if we're working on a project or we're working on gardening or whatever that thing is, instead of focusing on, oh my gosh, I've got to get all that done in a matter of whatever time, what does it take for us just to be available to other little things that want to come in through the day, to fill our hearts and remind us of what we're actually here for? We are here to be love, to share and interact and give love. Now, when I first walked in this morning, Elle said to me, I wrote a song for you. And this joy was in her face. And she says, you know, I wrote this song for you. And I was like, thank you. And she says, do you want to hear it? And, you know, I'm in another lane. Like, I'm thinking about my talk. And I said, I really do, but not right now, because I need to be about this. But it really was, I really did want to hear the song, and when you sing it, I'm going to be most grateful that you wrote it. So please know, I wasn't wanting to just brush you off. I was wanting to be with that exuberance, that zeal that you were expressing. And I know when you sing it, I will. So I just want to leave you with this. What does it take for you every day to be present enough so that if your day starts to go a little bit wonky, you don't spin out and allow it to take control of you and ruin everything you could possibly create, but to regroup, shoulders back, head up, and say, I got this, and I'm having a great day, because it's more important to have a joyful, great day than perhaps missing one or two things on your to-do list. They'll be there tomorrow, God willing. I appreciate your time. I thank you so much. Make a great day. Make a joyful noise. And know that that is what devotion is about for you. And you have that ability all day long to bring that inward. Bring that inward. Thank you. Namaste.
Thank you for that, Divine. Actually, we're going to have Amy. Hello. Amy is going to do the singing because it's got a lot of words. I took what the lady sent me and focused on what those words were, and it was this kind of devotion that that I was reading about has a lot to do with focus and realizing your power. And so Amy is gonna kill it. One. Thank you.
Mind over matter can make things better. We better get on it if we really want it. It's all about attention to our intention. Power and intensity's a fire in our belly. Cause where thought goes, power flows. Amplifying what's inside your mind, that's devotion. It's what we call devotion, and devotion's divine. Choose how we spend our time. Equanimity becomes unity, becomes easier and speedier. Consciousness blooms like a flower. Feel your power, creator on the earth. Believe in your worth, cause where thought goes, power flows. Amplifying what's inside your mind, that's devotion. It's what we call devotion, and devotion's divine. So open up your mind. Spiritual practice becomes experience. Then our dreams come into view. If we stay true to the focus we need, there is nothing we can't do. Because where thought goes, power flows. Amplifying what's inside your mind, that's devotion. It's what we call devotion, and devotion's divine. Open up your mind.
Amy Augenstein. Woo! Gerald Gates, Al Hager. Thank you, guys. She probably turned it up. It's a
switch on the side.
Yeah, little slide it up. That's all right. And what a beautiful song. And let's give Elle some love for putting that together. Woo, it feels really good to have music in the house, doesn't it? Oh my gosh, so grateful. So it's the time of our service where we normally in the past would have passed baskets about and to put your offerings in. And I would like to address a little something, if I have your permission. Is that yes?
Yes.
It was brought to my attention this week that we had signs up on our baskets. And the signs read, offering basket for green love. I was informed that that is a turnoff and it is offensive to some folks. So much so that they are choosing not to come to Unity because we had the term green love. It was a little upsetting to me because when I've had my opportunity to understand that God is all there is and that money is basically neutral, and I used to have a negative belief around money that it was caused misery. And so when I was going through looking at my beliefs and changing it to, well, it's really neutral. Money is just neutral, right? It doesn't have anything. But then I thought, well, because I had assigned a negative vibration that I got as a child, as sometimes we pick up beliefs at that point, subconscious beliefs, I said, what is the highest truth of vibrational energy that there is? And I thought, it's love. And Great Spirit had me change it and say, green love. In fact, I went to the CVS store and I got a heart stamp and I stamped all my checks. God is love. God, my checks are money is an expression of love. So because I was informed that it is bothersome and it has created some dislike of such things, we will not refer to money as green love, because even though Spirit told me that that's what it is and I've prayed on it and that was what came through,
I want to apologize to anyone that I have offended. Divine and Reverend Divine and I have offended in any way. It's not our intention. We see things differently. We're here to serve the community. So my apologies. It wasn't meant to create anything other than an expression of what we believe, that it is love and expression. So I hope you will accept my apologies. And we will just now do the prosperity blessing. We do have baskets. You'll see one up here, and there's one near the other door, and there's one in the middle table. So if you'd kindly put your donations that are here for that, we would appreciate it. And thank you so much for your generosity and your support in that way. We have a prosperity blessing, and because, again, we don't have a screen or a handouts, I'm going to invite you to just repeat after me if it feels right. And I'm not going to instruct you to put your hands on your heart, because I also was told that that's probably up to you to do if that's something that you choose. I do, and that's, everybody has a different way. So, divine love through me.
Divine love through me.
Blesses and multiplies.
Blesses and multiplies.
All that I am.
All that I am.
All that I give.
All that I give.
And all that I receive.
And all that I receive.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
And now we're going to have the prayer of protection, which I'm going to also lead in so that everyone gets to participate if that feels right to you. And there will be a little shift, and you may or may not notice it, but we'll see how it goes today. So the prayer of protection by James Dillett. The light of God surrounds us.
The light of God surrounds us.
We are the light.
We are the light.
The love of God unfolds us.
The love of God unfolds us.
We are the love.
We are the love.
The power of God protects us.
The power of God protects us.
We are the power.
We are the power.
The presence of God watches over us.
The presence of God watches over us.
We are the presence.
We are the presence.
Wherever we are, God is.
Wherever we are, God is.
And all is well.
And all is well.
And so it is.
And so it is.
And now our peace song with L.
Please join in if you know it. Yes, there is peace on earth.
Yes, there is peace on earth, and yes, it begins with me. Yes, there is peace on earth, a peace that was meant to be. With God as our creator, family all are we. As we walk with each other, in perfect harmony. Yes, peace begins with me. Yes, this is the moment now. With every step I take, this is my joyous vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Yes, there is peace on earth, and yes, it begins with me.
As I thought, ah, it's on. Yes. Just for all of us to give thanks for this time together, to go inward for just a moment, if that's comfortable for you, and to just know that as everything has unfolded in its right and perfect way in our shared time together, between the music, the message, the connection of community here together, that we all are able to go out into the world being the love and light that we are and make a contribution that creates a ripple effect, so that that is how unity demonstrates itself. It's not just in these four walls, it's out in our community, and that we be that presence
we be that light, we be that love, so that others get a chance to see that side of themselves and to remember that and to let that shine forth also. That you be safe, that you be well, that you have everything that you desire having this week. That you be blessed and know that you are loved. And until next week, and for those of you that are watching on a live stream, we are grateful for your presence, and whenever you choose to tune in, we wish you all of the above. Mm-hmm. Blessings. Go out and make a joyful noise. Thank you. So it is. I actually forgot.